Euzu billahi mineşşeytanirracim. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Essalatu vesselamu ala rasulina Muhammedin ve ala alihi ve sahbihi ve sellem. In the name of God. Hi everyone. In this lesson today, we learn the shortest chapter of the Quran. This chapter just 3 verses. I think you know this chapter and I think you have this chapter in your memory. Its name is Kawthar. This surah is known as a Meccan surah. Meccan means that this surah was revealed in the early Islamic years, the period of Mecca, the first chapter of the prophethood, the first period of the prophethood. First of all, I would like to tell you about this chapter's occasion of revelation, Sebeb-i Nuzul. As bin Wail, who was one of the chiefs of the pagans, chiefs of the mushriks, met the Prophet sallallahu aleyhi ve sellem coming out of the Kaaba. He spoke with him, with Prophet, for a while. In the meantime, a group of men of the Quraysh were sitting in the Kaaba and watching them from distance. When As bin Wail entered the Kaaba, they asked him, "To whom were you speaking?" He answered, "With this Abtar one." Abtar. He used this word Abtar. He used it for the Prophet to taunt him, to insult, to mock him. What's the means Abtar? Why they use this word for Prophet? The Arabs used to call the one who had no son Abtar. And Abtar means the animal whose tail is cut off. Our Prophet had 2 sons born of Khadija radiallahu anha, Qasim and Tahir. Tahir also called Abdullah. And they died in Mecca. And As bin Wail called Abtar to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And Allah subhanallah wa ta'ala sent this wonderful chapter, this wonderful surah to support our Prophet and use this word for mushrik. This is the occasion of revelation. And let's look at its translation. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. In the name of God, the first ayah, Inna a'tainaka al-kawthar. The first verse. O Prophet, we have granted you, we have given you the kawthar. And the second, Fasalli li rabbika wanhar. Pray only for your Lord and sacrifice. Inna shani'aka huwa al-abtar. Indeed, your enemy alone is cut off from the root. The name of Kawthar here. The full meaning of the word Kawthar as used here cannot perhaps be expressed in one word in any language of the world. We can explain the term Kawthar is the meaning of a lot of goodness, abundance, or blessing. What's the purpose of using the term, the Kawthar, here? A narration says that when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam sat on the pulpit and recited this surah, some of the companions asked him what it was that Allah had given him, and he answered, "It's a stream in heaven, wider than milk, more clear, brighter than a crystal." Some scholars also said the purpose of using the word Kawthar is for the pool of abundance, Hawdhul Kawthar, that belongs to the Prophet, wherefrom the believers quench their thirst when arriving in paradise. Let's look to the second verse, Fasalli li rabbika wanhar, pray only for your Lord and sacrifice. Because of the second verse, Muslims will sacrifice some animals soon. And Eid al-Adha. Eid al-Adha. Because in that verse, Allah said, pray for your Lord and sacrifice. On the virtue of the recitation of the surah, a tradition from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he says, he who recites it, this surah, Allah will quench his thirst from the streams of heaven and will recompense him good rewards as many as the number of every sacrifice which the servants of Allah make on the day of the feast of sacrifice. Dear guys, this lesson is finished here. See you next lesson, inshallah. Subhanaka la ilma lana illa ma 'allamtana innaka antal alimul hakim. Alhamdulillah rabbil alamin.